Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. In today's video, we're reviewing Slab, which is an internal wiki tool that teams can use to coordinate their team knowledge, everything from employee onboarding all the way to FAQs and information like that. So we're going to be reviewing that one in today's video. So let's jump in. Hello guys, welcome to this video today. We are reviewing Slab. We have it in front of us here. For those who are brand new to this channel, my name is Francesco. I'll be taking you through this application today. The main reason I've been exploring internal wikis a lot recently is because of the popularity of an application called Notion. So in today's video, we're looking at another resource that claims to be a useful wiki resource. So I've already created an account. You can access it from slab.com. You can go to your team once you've created an account, and I've created one for the Keep Productive team. Now, Slab is really simple. It claims to be a long-term memory for your team. So it's essentially trying to coordinate all of the wikis, documents that you have, and notes into one space so that whether you're a new employee or an older employee, and you need to know a bit of information, whether it's like how you coordinate the blog or what you need to do when you're setting up your new PC for the company, that it's all in one place for people to find. Now, there are a couple of alternatives to these, like wikis, like SlimWiki I know of. Coda is obviously becoming more popular and does a few more additional features, as well as Notion. And I will be reviewing a couple more like this application called Outline, etc. So guys, let's jump in. This application can be used for pretty much anything. I'm going to be demoing with the features today, giving you the pricing and giving you general opinion of the application. So as we can see, this is Slab in front of us. On this left-hand panel, we have basically the sidebar. You can actually find everything you need to know in terms of navigation. You've got home. Home will take you to this page here so that you can see all of the recently viewed features, as well as any favorites that you've saved. You can also access drafts here too. Drafts are when you're creating a post or a wiki inside of here and you're yet to publish it. You can pretty much go in there and continue to draft it. Now you've also got favorites here, and once you save those favorites using the star option, you can access them from here. So that could be your favorite posts. Then you've got something called topics. You can create a new topic, but let me just click show all because that will demonstrate what it can look like. You can create almost a structure to everything. So for example, like in this demonstration, if you had a company, you could have their roadmap here, the vision, the mission, any onboarding documents, any templates that are pre-created, and any department that all of these documents relate to. So it's quite a nice experience in terms of finding anything you need to know. So this can be really accessible. Now, if you want to hide away that navigation bar when you're inside of a wiki, then you can do just by tapping that there. Now you have got a search bar on there on the top. I will demonstrate some of the integrations that you can get a bit later, but let's just dive into an example. So for example, if I clicked on company, I would basically be met by this page. And what you have when you click inside of a topic is you have all of the posts that are relevant to it. So for example, this sort of reminds me of Podio, like a social networking application, almost like a team collaboration tool, but posts essentially are your wikis. So for example, they've got a few sample ones here, like getting a new laptop. So for example, if a company provides laptops, you could have a available model selection here and embed using Google Forms a laptop request form that you could use quite easily here. So it's quite a neat way of being able to do it. And of course, you've got, once you're inside of the post or the wiki here, you can actually access the different areas. And if this was longer, you'd be able to see all of that. So at the top right-hand corner, you can edit the post if you like. Editing the post is really easy. I played around with a few and I will be demonstrating what this looks like. But you can pretty much add any form of multimedia that you like, whether that's images, links, files, whatever. And if, for example, you can text format with links and comments and leave them for your team. Now, if you want to unpublish this, you can go to the top right, you can favorite it. And if I hit favorite, you can see it appears in this left-hand side. And also you can export it and make a copy of it. And you can export into docx markdown PDF, as well as view the history. You can actually see who's edited it, what comments have been left by other people. So it's not just a static post. Now you can also share it. You can actually create a public link for anyone that wants to view it, or you can add specific owners that already joined in. So it's quite an easy way. And also I did see that they have real-time sync in this as well. So if you were editing, if someone else was editing this, you'd be able to see exactly who's doing that, which is good. So if I go over and I begin to create a new, for example, let's go on onboarding. Let's say for the keep productive side of stuff, we have the blog. Let's say I wanted to create a quick onboarding document for those who are new to the blog and just want to get started. If I click create in the top right hand corner, you create a new post, and this is automatically available in your drafts. You can see that that's a draft now. And of course you can see, if you click into yourself, you can see all of the posts that you've created beforehand. So that's quite a quick and nice shortcut there. So for example, if I wanted to say blog editors guidelines, and I could get started straight away. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to craft a post. I'm going to speed it up so that you can see the sort of text formatting that I have the ability to create. So here we are, a really simple demonstration of how the post work. For example, when you get started, I added a header to this document, a post, and you can also add these headers as you go throughout. So for example, I added three core H2 headers. I outlined a bit of the information on the site, how to create a new blog post, and obviously this is very condensed, and creating header images. And I also dragged an image into this one and it saved it beautifully. Now, things that I didn't add, it also allows you to add obviously more images. You've got video, you've got embedding. So if you wanted to add embedded code or, for example, a YouTube video, you could do so. You can mention another post or mention another user, ordered list, bulleted list, or a checklist. So that, for example, if you want to make a quick checklist that is interacted, you can even add code, tables, I believe that is, and also the additional horizontal line. So they're all accessible through just tapping this plus button, media button down here. And as you can see, it's already coordinated the outline of the post as well, so you don't have to. Now, once I'm happy, what I would do is I'd press publish. And as you can see, you can add topics to it and actually assign it to. So for example, company onboarding, if I hit publish and I go down to show all, you should be able to see that inside of there. So there we go, it's available in the post section inside of onboarding. Now, if I wanted to favorite a topic specifically, I could do, and of course I can access all of the topics below there. And if I want to create a new post, it's quite easy here. Now, inside of each topic page, you can actually see the top contributors, the subtopics, and any activities that have been edited since you've been there, which is quite easy. And if you want to, you can go into other articles and actually share or publish them straight from there. So as you can imagine, there are a few templates inside of here. So if I go to show all, hit templates, you can see a few that they've created, like meeting notes templates and project overview. So this could be a project overview template that you created. And naturally you could see the goals, non-goals, team goals. And you can even with each post thank each people. So you can use a couple of templates. If you're going to create a new topic, there are a few templated ones here. So for example, if you wanted a department for planning and developing, helping, winning, drawing, there's loads there that you can do it, and you can nest them underneath specific other topics. Now you're probably wondering, when it comes to pricing and information like that, how does everything work? They have a free trial, which is 30 days. They also have a pricing, I think it's 10 users annually, as a price is $25 per month for those 10 users. They also have a business edition of it with improved authentication and premium integrations, and that's $50 per user per month. Now, the notable thing is they've got a few integrations with GitHub, Google Drive, Slack, Airtable, Dropbox Paper, G Suite, YouTube, and future integrations with Atlassian products coming soon. They also have the ability to manage history management. I think this was founded by previous employees of Airbnb, Dropbox, and Y Combinator. Now, just before we go, I wanted to demonstrate the Google Drive integration. I connected up with a Google Drive Mini to demonstrate. For example, if you already have a Google Drive full of documents and you want to be able to start editing some to obviously Slab, but you still want to access all your Google Drive, you can do that here. So for example, if I typed in like a couple of projects or done a search that quickly finds inside of Google Drive. So for example, I could find all the Google Drive, and once I hit enter, it would open up that Google Drive document, and I could even add a folder to it. So that's quite a neat way, and you can obviously search and add more integrations like Dropbox Paper and Slack to make it searchable as well. Anyway, guys, hopefully that was a nice overview. As I said, I wanted to be doing more internal wiki tools because this is quite a popular space. I think companies are leaning their way towards these tools because, as you can imagine, there's tons of them, and all that knowledge and information that a company's got can be found and accessed there. Anyway, guys, a huge thank you for stopping by today. If you're brand new to the Keep Productive YouTube channel, please hit the subscribe button. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. And if you want to leave a comment with any thoughts or feedback, or you want to leave some ideas for internal wiki features in the future, please do leave them there too. Anyway, guys, huge thank you, and I will see you in a future video. Cheers.